Welcome back to Learnwake. This is Brandon Judd, and I am responding to a video analysis request that's been submitted by Ditri here. This is on a tantrum attempt, and in your submission, you mentioned that when you're trying the tantrum, you're always falling and landing switch or blind. Please help me figure out what I'm doing wrong. I was trying everything, but the backside 180 rotation is still in there. Thank you for that description. That helps me understand kind of what you think you're experiencing, so I can kind of see where your head's at. Also, you mentioned in the comments here of the video, it says the attempts timeline is inverted. The first attempt is my last, and that helps me a lot too. So we'll go ahead and watch your last attempt, and then we'll watch your first attempt, and we can kind of see what's going on here and why this is digressing. This first one, or sorry, I guess this last one technically, where you're landing a tantrum to blind practically, is very common when people have one particular thing that they do, and it's actually the opposite problem that I have, but it's in the same category. So the issue is that you're looking over a one of your shoulders really hard. When you're flipping. So if we were to play and pause here, at this point in the flip, you start trying to spot your landing over your left shoulder. And what that does is it spins your shoulders a little bit. Your head will control where you go on this. Spins your shoulders a little bit, and then you don't have a ton of line tension to keep you straight. And because you spotted the water over that shoulder, your lower body starts following. And rather than catch a back edge, you keep going with it. So this was developed over time. You can see if you are to watch this video, they start getting better and better as the video goes on, which means that because it's backwards here, you started out really good and then it got worse and worse, which is really common. A lot of people have like really good, like beginner's luck, if you will. Then they start getting comfortable and start relaxing and not staying really disciplined on the pieces of the trick that are required to keep it functioning right. So if that makes sense. So let's watch this one again and look how we'll slow it down here. But we'll look how good your head stays in position. You look pretty much straight up. And then you trip the board really well here also. You're not throwing your head back and throwing your shoulders back behind you. Rather, you're just kind of going up with your chin and chest toward the sky and letting the tripping motion of the board take you the rest of the way around. So we'll take a peek here if this will function for me. So you stand up nice and tall, and you don't really like look over one shoulder too hard. Which is nice. So that's why this one functioned so well. Your takeoff was really clean and nice, and then your head, you didn't really pause at the water. You just kind of looked all the way through your flip to your landing. So eventually, as time went on, that got worse and worse, to where you were looking over that shoulder. So the fix here is I'm not sure if you have access to a trampoline at all. But that's the best way to overcome these issues. What you would want to do on the trampoline is you would want to be able to do a tantrum with a backside 180 and a frontside 180, very controllably from both directions. So with and without the rope. But you looking over that shoulder is going to be kind of spinning you weird. You're also really aggressively switching edges. So you're coming in really aggressive here, and then you're letting your backhand off the handle real early. And then as soon as you finish popping, when you switch edges here, you look kind of away and really over square your shoulders right there. And you take your back shoulder here and kind of bring it toward the boat. And that makes you flip on kind of a funky axis. Like I should. This front hip and your back hip should be in line with the rope right now. They shouldn't be vertically aligned like this. And that's because of your head and because of where you send your shoulders into the flip. But like I said, I would practice on the trampoline. If you can do a 360, a tantrum with a 360 in one direction and the other direction, that will give you a lot of really, really strong air awareness. If you can't quite get to that point, you should at least be able to do a tantrum with a backside 180 and a tantrum with a frontside 180 on the trampoline, so you know what it feels like in the air and you can correct for it. That's going to really help your awareness here a lot more and keep you from cheating and looking over your shoulder. So my problem is I look over my front shoulder, so I end up kind of frantruming. It ends up being part of a front flip and part of a tantrum because I don't ever like to look away from where I'm going in my tantrum. I like to see the wake for too long through this, and so I end up going front side, whereas your problem is you go backside, and that comes from peeking over one shoulder instead of looking straight up at the sky until your horizon levels out again. So that's kind of the long and the short of it, but the drills to work on are on the trampoline. Or you can also try and overcompensate the other direction. So try and take off, and instead of looking over your left shoulder when you take off, try looking over your right shoulder and replicate the problem that I have. And if you can hit both extremes, then you should be able to find that middle, which is why I say try that on the trampoline first, because there would be a lot less scary impacts here on the water. But if you don't have access to a trampoline, just trying to look over the other shoulder instead might actually correct itself. You may think you're looking over your right shoulder when you take off, but you're actually doing it properly, and you may start landing these again. So good luck with that. Hopefully that helps. In the meantime, if you'd like, we have a new tantrum video here up on the site. So I would take a peek at this. And I would watch this video and just kind of see if there are any other little things you see in that. But this is Brandon Lee here on his tantrum, and he does a couple good tantrums here, and then there's a few that they show of bad examples. And you can kind of learn from that a bit. It's always fun to review the trick you're working on when we have new content coming out from it. So good luck, and if you have any questions, you can. You can send us a reply here. You can upload another video of you trying another attempt, and we can get you dialed in. Thanks again.